Right, so we've already looked at one Brian May solo, and that's Bohemian Rhapsody, which is probably the most famous one. But he was a great player, and he all of his solos were great. And this is another good one too, Crazy Little Thing Called Love. It's more bluesy, and it's not so long. Still a bit of tricky bits in there. So let me play it for you, and you can see how it goes. Check out the record though, Crazy Little Thing Called Love by Queen. Nice solo that, isn't it? Nice and bluesy, and you want to get a clean sound on your guitar if you can. So let me play play it. I've played it through. I've said that already. I won't make that mistake again. What I'll do is I'll show you how to play it. So here is the first lick of the solo. Nice little lick, isn't it? Kind of a nice blues lick. So what you're doing here is double stop, 10, I'm sorry, on the B, 10 on the high E, slide into it. So you're going like that, all right? So four times. And I'm sliding there just from one fret below. And then you're doing this lick. So what I'm doing here is I'm bending up 13 on the B, up a whole step, but killing it with my right hand. So you've got that. All right, let me play you that with the other lick. So you're kind of doing that twice. And then the second time, or the third time, then you're bending it up, let down, and pull off to the 11 on the B. So, okay, so far you've got this. And the last bit he plays is 13 on the B and 11 on the B, okay? And the last little tag he does is 13, slide 13 up to 15 on the B, hit 13 on the high E. So all together, you've got this. So that's the first lick. Here's the second lick. Kind of similar. Do the same thing. Slide into 10 on the B, 10 on the high E. Three times this time. And then play 12 on the G, 12 on the B. And then double stop 10 on the G, 10 on the B. But very quickly, hammer on with your second finger to the 11 on the G. So it goes. And then he goes kind of back a bit and he does this lick. Which is really cool. I really like that. So that's 10 hammer on to 11 on the G. 10 on the B, 12 on the B, and then double stop 10 on the B, 10 on the high E. And you get that. So all together that lick sounds. All right, kind of phrase number two. Here's the next one. So that is, you're bending up 13 up a whole step to 15. Take your little finger and put it on the 13th fret on the high E. So when you bend up, keep that bent up and hit 13 on the high E. And you do that three times, so you get that move. And then let it down, pull off to 11 on the B, and then the same move you did before, 13 to 11 on the B. So let me play that slowly. And then you have that little tag again. 13 up to 15, finish on 13 on the high E. All right, so let me play you what we've got so far. Okay, I made a little mistake in there. Did you spot that? Don't do that. All right, here's the last lick. Now, this is a really cool one. Now, it's very important with this lick to know what fingers you're using. So, you're double stopping 12 on the B, 12 on the high E. Okay, then go to 15 on the B to 12 on the high E. Okay, now I'm doing that with my third finger. Now watch this is important. And then slide into this 14th fret here on the B with your second finger. So, okay, the reason you're doing that is because the next note you're playing is 14 on the G. So, I'd practice that real slow. Okay, and then 16 on the D, 14 on the D, and then finish here on the 14th fret on the G. Now I say finish because it sounds like you should go, which would be a nice lick, but he continues it, he does. So you play that twice. And then you bend up 16 on the G, let it down, okay? And then pull off to 14 on the G. And then 16 again on the G to 14 on the G. So let me play you that lick slowly. Now, as always, when you play these licks, the tone is very important. You don't want to bend things out of tune, you know. If I played this bit, that's in tune, but imagine I did this. Now, that's not right. You can hear that. Hopefully, you can hear that. So make sure your bends are... So try and put some feeling into these notes if you can. So let me play it through for you without the backing track from start to end. So I hope you enjoyed that solo. The nice thing about it is it's got some nice little licks in which you kind of rip off and put in your own playing, you know, which will sound great. So have some fun with that. See you next time.